The World Bank announced a decision to halt new loans to Uganda over the controversial anti-homosexuality law last week. President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni responded to this action on his Twitter handle and denounced the World Bank's decision to suspend new funding. Museveni vowed to find alternative sources of credit. Speaking to journalists in Kampala, the civil society activists under their umbrella body, the Civil Society Budget Advocacy Group, CSBAG, expressed worry that the decision by the World Bank has far-reaching consequences on the realization of the country's Vision 2040 and the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals 2030. Some of the likely negative impacts to the country that the activists pointed out include increase in economic inequality amid the growing level of poverty, reduced financing in the social sectors, increased pressure for commercial loans and domestic borrowing, effect on the country's foreign exchange stability, negative effect on the financial sector and the private sector growth.
Decision like this, then you go back to your stock of debt and then you say, what is likely to happen? Besides loans, Uganda receives grants from World Bank, and by 21st December 2022, Uganda had received grants amounting to $204 million. These are grants, money that are given without interest. And we know that almost 85% was allocated to human capital development, where education and health consultation fall.
World Bank has over the years offered financing to support Uganda's development agenda. And to date, Uganda has 30 active World Bank projects and 13 in the pipeline, which amount to 51 trillion shillings. Besides loans, Uganda also receives grants from the World Bank, and by 21st December last year, Uganda had received grants amounting to $205 million, of which the largest share was for human capital development, including education, health, water, and sanitation. The decision by the World Bank rose a number of debates, as legislators also asked government to cut on its expenditure early this week.
You see, Midu, we have been talking about this. New cities that are coming up with lights, new streets, you know, is worth 555 billion. So the number of projects that definitely, and most roads in this country, you can touch with them and you will be seeing, you're able to see World Bank money. Now, people would say, no, World Bank money, yes, it's a loan, we are supposed to pay it back. But it's one of, they provide what we call concessional loans, loans that are affordable. Interest rates range from 1% to 3%. The grace period is 40 years. It's different from the other loans, the other ones of NASA Street.
Bank, IMF, and all these institutions and countries is to respect the legislative sovereignty of Uganda and Ugandans. Unless they want to tell us that each time we want to make a law, we should first consult America or World Bank and IMF. Please, we are consulting you. Will this law be acceptable to you? Then if they say it is acceptable, we bring it back to Parliament and debate it. But then where will that leave our legislative sovereignty?
This goes back to the government, especially the government officials. The president inclusive. They have for so long been extravagant. They've been getting loans. They've been getting grants, and they have been misusing that money. Now that the money lender, who has been actually helping us, is stepping aside, now that even those ones who were actually willing to help us, just giving us grants, they are quitting, that means we are going to be like, we are in a dilemma.
It is a learning curve. Once somebody has denied you a loan, he gives you ability to think better. So, and there are very many international friends from whom we can borrow. So,
in the same vein, the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, revealed that government had plans to revise the national budget downwards to mitigate the potential financial impact of the lending suspension by the World Bank.
We took the decision, and we are firm, but we knew, and the president told us, that we are going this route. Should it develop, should it bring consequences, then we should be able
to adjust.
we should be able to bear.
Civil society activists believe the World Bank projects have had a direct impact on the people and can never be underlooked. Among these is the $555 billion project which caters for refugees in the country, the $370 billion project for the skills development, which has benefited more than 82,000 youth. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.